I joined a religion that lets you have two wives.
I don't want two wives.
Did you give me a lift home?
Herb, I don't go anywhere near your home, ever.
We could go to your home.
Oh, good night, Mr. Carlson.
Good night, Bailey. Boy, am I bushed.
Why?
Huh? Lucille told me not to come home tonight. I want you to know that.
Johnny, what are you doing here?
I overslept. I'm late.
Johnny, it's 5:30 p.m.
Not morning?
No, you're not on the air for 12 and a half hours.
Hold up.
Then let me tell you something else, young lady. I get a lot of work done behind that closed door.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Carlson, but my mind is on getting to the bank.
Anybody want to get breakfast?
Johnny, what are you doing here?
Well, I came in a little early this morning.
Hey, that sounds like a fire.
What is it?
Come on, take a look. Hey, fire engine. What?
Wow, a whole bunch of them.
They're slowing down. That must be very close. They're stopping.
I smell
right,
smoke.
Right in front of the building, downstairs.
Johnny, do you smell smoke?
No, just me. When I came through the lobby, it was real kind of foggy.
Baby, if you've ever wondered whatever became of me, I'm living on the air in Cincinnati, Cincinnati WKRP. In a while, I'm at WKRP in Cincinnati.
The time of transition is upon us, when the warmth of day pales to the cool blue of night. At 5:33 on Friday, this is Venus, my children, coming to you from the top of the Flim building.
Quick time!
This turntable is stuck again, Andy.
Come on, it's Friday night.
Yeah, blew my whole segue.
Yeah, listen, I'll think about that on Monday. Right now, I gotta rush somewhere to meet someone to do something that is more important than the invention of radio itself. Hey, I can see you.
I had this thing timed to the second, man. Unlike fever, I prepare for my show.
Monday. I got big plans this weekend.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'll tell you this much. It involves an airplane, a breathing apparatus, and a young woman.
Venus, relinquish your show.
Be cool, I'm not in the mood, Les.
Andy, if you don't make him relinquish his show, I won't be responsible.
You're not responsible, Les.
I'm the news director.
A stewardess has taken old Travis to the Bahamas. A whole weekend of nothing but snorkeling.
Flames fill fifth floor Flim building. Firemen fight fierce conflagration.
What?
Flames fill fifth floor Flim building. Firemen fight fierce conflagration.
I don't see flames anywhere.
Did you see anything, Johnny?
When?
When you came in.
Bailey, when I hear sirens, I don't look back.
I'll bet it's that chili parlor next door. They've been begging for a fire.
Oh, there you all are.
Andy, there's a fire in a building right on this block.
Yeah, I know. We're in it.
Huh?
We are? We can't be. I've got to get to the bank.
Yeah, I've got 12 and a half hours to kill, man.
I've got to go. Where is it I've got to go?
Now, look, wait a minute, everybody. So far, it's contained to the fifth floor. Let's just everyone keep their heads about this.
Right.
Goodbye, all. Wait a minute. Venus.
It's quitting time, man.
Venus.
Look.
Venus.
It's okay. Les is on the air. He's interviewing a fireman. Did you know he's nuts?
Did you know you're not supposed to take an elevator during a fire? Am I right or am I wrong?
Now, who volunteered to be fire warden on this floor? Now, who is supposed to know what to do?
I feel safe.
We will all exit via the fire stairs.
And now, wait a minute. First of all, you got to take the precaution of feeling that door to be sure that it's not warm.
Andy?
It's cool.
All right, I'm going to go get Les a check for stragglers while you all walk in an orderly.
Oh, no. Where are the other doors? Huh, Andy?
I don't know. He's the warden.
This is it.
Okay, look.
I may not know exactly what's going on here, but I do know this. The elevator is safe because Herb and Jennifer were getting on when I got off, and they are not trapped up here. They are safe.
We should be together. It's a sign from God.
Dial again.
Occupied. See? I can't even get a ringing sound downstairs. We could be alone here all night.
Impossible. Did you have something to do with this?
Me?
Venus is still in his office.
Didn't even dream anything this good.
KRP.
Andy, Jennifer.
Jennifer.
We're stuck near the 8th floor.
Tell him there's no hurry.
Quiet. What fire?
Fire?
Well, now, look, a fire is probably too strong a word. A little smoldering on 5. I'm sure it's out by now.
Can't you go down and check?
Down here?
Well, now you see you've hit on the problem.
You're trapped like we are?
Who are?
Now, look, Les already has a fire official on the phone. I'm going to go talk with him, and I'll get someone from down the hall, VDAS, to come in here and stay on the line with you. By any chance, are the elevator doors warm?
Are the doors warm?
There's no fire down here. Are you talking to anybody?
No, Andy.
Good. Why don't you and Herb see if you can't pry open those doors and see if you can't pop out on the floor you're between?
Pop out.
So if I may paraphrase you, Officer Shanks, for my great many listeners, you allege that this raging sea of flame is contained on the 5th floor.
Something like that. You see, with sprinklers...
Officer Shanks, explain fire.
What?
Exactly why do things burn?
What kind of radio station is this?
Andy?
Excuse me, Officer Shanks. May I speak to you a second, sir? We're not on the air right now.
This is a prank.
No, sir, this is Andy Travis, program director of WKRP Radio.
Okay.
Sir, we're on the 14th floor of the Flynn building.
You're kidding. You people ought to get out of there. But don't take the elevator. Take the fire steps.
Well, sir, there's a doggone bunch of smoke on those steps.
Shouldn't be. I bet somebody propped open a fire door on the 5th floor. People do that.
Don't worry, Andy. They've got ladders.
Not to the 14th floor.
Helicopters?
Not to speak of.
Mets?
Too windy. Look, you'll be fine. It's a small fire, I hear. Sit tight and stay low.
Sir, we have a problem, and we have two people trapped in one of those elevators just a few floors below between the 8th and the 9th floors.
Tell you what, we'll work on getting a man up to them. Stay cool.
Uh-huh. Well, how about if one of us could figure out a way to get down to them from up here?
Well, I can't officially advise you to do something like that.
Right, I understand. Okay, thank you very much.
This is a vault. Why couldn't this have been made in a foreign country by people who don't know what they're doing? Why?
It's getting stuffy in here. Isn't it getting stuffy in here?
Jennifer, I don't want to die in this suit.
Andy, they won't open. What do we do now?
Well, I think the smart thing to do... Hello. Jennifer? It's dead.
Uh-huh. What did the fire fellow say?
Fine. There's no problem.
Sure.
Yeah. Give me that thing.
No!
I got an idea, didn't I?
But I thought you said there was no problem.
Oh, sure.
Well, then give me back my hose, man!
I understand, Andy.
Andy? Andy! Help! Help!
He says we have nothing to worry about, Herb.
Oh, sure.
Really? The fire is out.
It is?
Mm-hmm. Well, yes, it was quite a scare, but Herb calmed me down. He's quite a hero.
I'm pretty used to disasters, Andy.
Well, we'll just wait here and relax, then. Herb, you don't have to take anything else off.
Let me talk to him.
Oh, Andy, Herb would like to talk to you. Oh, okay. He put us on hold.
Hold? Come on. Oh,
okay, now, Johnny, be careful. The broom, I've got it wedged right in there.
Just be careful, Johnny. It's a long
Hold
way
on.
Down.
Come on.
Oh, be careful.
All right, look, here's the deal.
Oh.
I put a little loop in this hose here. We're going to lower someone down to the top of the elevator. There's a trap door there. We'll open up the trap door and get them both out of there.
Wait a minute. You said we had nothing to worry about.
Right, sure. All right, who's the passenger? Well, I thought of the idea. I did my part. Okay, I want to go.
Do you know what you're saying?
It's a possibility, sure. Who else have you got? Okay, I'll go. No, I want to go. Look, it's a chance to leap into the jaws of death. What a great way to start a morning. Come on.
Andy, you can't let him do this.
Are you volunteering?
Well, I mean, if his heart's set on it.
But wait a minute. You said that we need somebody who's in great physical shape.
Right.
Oh,
I'm the warden. I should go.
We'll go with Johnny.
Okay.
Are you serious?
Let him go. All right. Watch him go, Johnny. Watch the broom.
I hope you remember this when you wake up.
Slack.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Tense.
I got it.
You got it?
Brooke,
sit down. All
right. Okay.
Ah. Oh.
Watch.
Man.
Is this the way to Kansas?
The phones are dead. The phones are dead.
Not now, Les.
Well, shouldn't we call somebody?
Les, please.
First, I thought that fireman hung up on me. Hi, Johnny. But then I figured it out.
What in the hell? Oh.
What the hell am I doing here?
Somewhere over the ninth floor.
Wait, Johnny!
What do you think, Andy?
That's ridiculous.
Let me down about two more flyers, guys.
Will you get that switchblade out of my eyes?
I keep it hidden in my desk. I'm always prepared for the worst.
Oh, just do it, Les.
It's my lantern.
I'm the warden. Just do it.
Get that thing tied off back there, warden. He's getting heavy.
Don't worry, Johnny.
Look, it's so bright you can see through my hand.
I don't get it. I mean, I can understand him forgetting about me down here, but you're down here too.
Who?
Travis.
Hang up, Herb.
Yeah, but how's Andy going to talk to him?
He can't.
But you said... I thought that he... Holy smoke. No. Not smoke.
Would you put your arm around me? Herb, I'm frightened. Please?
Shall I sit down or you want to stand up?
Doesn't matter. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
We're going to be just fine. Things always work out for me. No, of course not. It's just the smoke.
Yeah. I know why this is happening. God wants me out of the way, and he's burning down a whole building to do it. He's been working on this all my life. Yeah, the heart trouble. I've had it. Drinking problem? That's me. Real estate? I bought a home in the only neighborhood in the whole world where the property values have gone down. My best friend is Les. Lucille thinks sex is a reward. Come on, Herb. Mow the lawn or no num-nums tonight.
You know what? We should do something to take our minds off this.
Tarzan won't be free of this place.
Get that switchblade out of my eyes.
Don't worry, John. Tarzan find letter. Tarzan no need silly fire hose.
I have an idea.
Let's hear it.
I'll tell you a secret about me. Something I've never told anyone else. And then you tell me a secret about you.
Who goes first?
I will.
Okay.
Herb, tonight, Friday night, instead of doing something madly expensive with someone dashing and wealthy and intriguing, I was just going to go home alone and curl up in front of the fire with a book. A paperback romance. And there have been more evenings like this than I care to mention.
No. Yeah. No.
8 in the last year. Okay, it's your turn.
No. I don't have anything to compare with that.
Oh, come on, a man like you must have all kinds of secrets.
Well, there is something.
Good.
Since we're trapped like rats.
Herb.
I want to confess something to you while I still have the chance.
Come on. Just say it.
I tell every man I meet that you and me, that me and you, that the two of us are.
You do?
On a regular basis. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm just glad I had a chance to tell you in this last moment of.
Hi. Mind if I watch?
Yeah. I should have jumped into the jaws of death. I mean, I am the fire warden.
Easy, easy.
He's coming. Shove it, Mr. Carlson.
Huh?
I said, shove it.
Oh. Johnny, give me the light, baby. Give me the light.
I'll do it.
Give it to me, Les.
Can you hear me, Johnny?
Hey, there's no tension.
Huh?
I don't know.
What's my gosh?
Huh?
All we've got is the shaft.
This ended up on the roof.
Oh, Johnny, I could hug you, I could squeeze you, I could kiss you to death.
Yeah, you climbed down that dark, dangerous, dirty hole to save our miserable necks, huh?
No, just to bring you this broom.
Oh, how can we ever thank you?
I think Jennifer mentioned something.
Oh, Johnny, please just get me out of here.
Well, just let me get my hands on something electric. Out of the way, Tarlick.
You're right.
Aha! We had him like this in Nam.
You were never in Vietnam.
Oh.
Way to go, John.
The elevator's moving. The elevator's moving.
You're in the way, Les.
Well, this is great. Now we'll all be trapped together.
Will you get that out of my eyes?
14th floor, women's lingerie, and other hobby equipment.
Yeah. Hey!
Tell you something. There's a ladder going all the way down the shaft. I could have walked.
Shh. We were trapped down there between the 8th and 9th.
All I had to do was touch two wires together. Like that. Now I can probably do something about these lights.
That's my buddy John. Did you see that? That's him, huh?
Well, that was broken completely down.
I probably fixed that.
Excuse me. Mr. Carlson, fire warden, 14th floor, Flimbley.
Mr. Fire Department, is the phone working okay?
Well, yeah, great, you know, for a dead phone.
The two
fire department. They're both fine, yeah. Elevator works great, too.
Fire's out,
really?
All safe. Go on home.
Yeah, fine, sure. The
Fire's out. It's all over.
Yeah, I was just getting into it.
So, I guess that's it then, huh?
Yeah. In the news game, we'd call it a 30.
Johnny, I thought you were incredible.
Yeah. I think we were all pretty darn heroic.
We were all pretty darn something, huh? Yeah.
I want to thank each and every one of you, especially Herb.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what are we all hanging around here for? I mean, I know Jennifer has a big evening planned.
I almost forgot.
Hey,
you devil.
I better go put on a record.
Wrong way.
Right.
Yeah.
Listen, you want to get some breakfast?
Oh, well, I do have to go to the bank.
Yes, I've got an island paradise to get to. I can't say no more.
Oh, well, gosh, I got to go. Where do I have to go?
Yeah. Don't wait on me.
Let's go.
Okay. Just think, a few minutes ago, this very elevator was a death trap.
Was it scary down there, Herb?
Scary? Takes more than a stalled elevator and a few flames to ruffle the feathers of Herbert R. Tarley Jr.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. See you, Herb.